grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Do please be seated. Welcome to this evensong in preparation, in vigil for the funeral of late Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, who has affected all our lives, possibly all our lives long. And those of us who've been participating in events in other parishes, but also perhaps within the diocese, or even going up to London, will have been deeply moved by the response of not only the nation, but also those spread across the globe who send their good wishes to us in our grief. The Axtell family have also been bereaved recently, and Vicky Axtell's funeral will coincide with Her Majesty's tomorrow at 11 o'clock. I don't think you can catch up with Vicky's online, whereas you might be able to catch up with the Queen's online. So if you wish to attend her funeral at West Park's crematorium, the instruction is not to wear black, but to bring colour and celebrate Vicky's life with her family and give thanks for all she gave to us as a community here. If you find 6 o'clock on a Sunday evening appeals as a time to come for evening prayer, on the first and the third Sundays of the month, we have evening prayer, first Sunday of the month at Hampstead Norris, and on the third Sunday of the month here, both at 6 o'clock. We come to the bidding prayer. Dearly beloved, we praise the Almighty and Eternal God for his love revealed in Jesus Christ. We thank him that his love is greater than we can ever imagine and stronger than death itself. So we know that we can trust him with our loved ones and with ourselves. Though we enter this house of prayer with sorrow in our hearts, we lift up our hearts in gratitude for all his blessings to us. Though we come as people burdened by fear and guilt, we rejoice in the forgiveness he always offers to us. Though we walk amidst the shadows of death, we celebrate his promise of new life. Though our hearts are filled with grief, we do not grieve as those without hope. In these days of national mourning, we recall with gratitude our late Queen Elizabeth and the gifts which God gave to her, and all the ways in which our Heavenly Father sustained her throughout her long life and reign. We give thanks for this nation, for its people and its places, the human tapestry of young and old, men and women, city dwellers and country folk, our many creeds and customs, our diverse places and histories, yet bound together on this night as one people. May the God of the open heart, and the Christ of the gentle joy, and the Holy Spirit of the embracing love grant to each one of us gathered here the grace that enhances each life and our communities. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, we pray. Amen. I invite you to stand and join in our first hymn, The Day Thou Gavest, Lord, Is Ended, number 16.
Oh,
us to give the light of the knowledge of his glory in the face of Christ. But we have this treasure in earthen vessels to show that the transcendent power belongs to God and not to us. As we acknowledge our human frailty, let us call to mind, in a moment of stillness, our sins of word, of deed, and of omission, and confess them before God, our Father. Lord, you raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the broken in heart. Christ, have mercy. Lord, you make one by your Holy Spirit the torn and divided. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open thou our lips,
and our mouths shall show forth thy praise.
O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, it is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Praise ye the Lord.
The Lord's name be praised.
I invite you to stand and join in the setting of Psalm 23. The Lord's my shepherd, I'll not want. Hymn number 426.
Thank you.
Thank you.
must put on immortality. When this perishable body puts on imperishability, and this mortal body puts on immortality, then the saying it is written will be fulfilled. Death has been swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved, be steadfast, immovable, always excelling in the work of the Lord, because you know that in the Lord your labour is not in vain. Here ends the second lesson.
Our next evening hymn number 13, Abide with Me, Fast Fall of Eventide, echoes those verses from the first letter to the Corinthians. Hymn number 13, Abide with Me.
Thank you.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show thy mercy upon us,
and grant us thy salvation.
O Lord, save the King,
and mercy hear us when we call upon thee.
Endue thy ministers with righteousness,
and make thy chosen people joyful.
O Lord, save thy people,
and bless thy inheritance.
Give peace in our time, O Lord.
Because there is none other that fighteth for us, but only thou, O Lord.
O God, make clean our hearts within us,
and take our kindly spirit from us.
O God, the maker and redeemer of all mankind, grant us with thy servant Queen Elizabeth and all the faithful departed the sure benefits of thy Son's saving passion and glorious resurrection, that in the last day, when all things are gathered up in Christ, we may with them enjoy the fullness of thy promises, through Jesus Christ thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, one God, world without end. Amen. God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ our Saviour. Amen. Amen. Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thy only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. The prayer of remembrance and thanksgiving for her late Majesty. O Lord, our Heavenly Father, almighty and everlasting God, by whom kings reign and princes decree justice, we remember before thee our late Sovereign Lady, Queen Elizabeth, in thankfulness for the blessings which thou hast bestowed upon her by her reign, for the example she set of unwearied devotion to duty, for her steadfast courage, and for the love of love and loyalty borne to her by a great family of peoples in all parts of the world. And we beseech thee to give us grace that, having these mercies in remembrance, we may with one heart and one mind set forward the welfare of this land and hasten the coming of thy kingdom of peace and goodwill among humankind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Prayer of John Donne. Bring us, O Lord God, at our last awakening into the house and gate of heaven, to enter into that gate and dwell in that house, where there shall be no darkness nor dazzling, but one equal light, no noise nor silence, but one equal music, no fears nor hopes, but one equal possession, no ends nor beginnings, but one equal eternity, in the habitations of thy majesty and glory, world without end. Amen. As we remember the Axtell family and the royal family, we pray for those who mourn. Almighty God, Father of all mercies and giver of all comfort, deal graciously, we pray thee, with all those who mourn, the members of the royal family, this nation and all nations of the Commonwealth, casting every care on thee, we may know the consolation of thy love through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, who rulest over all the kingdoms of the world, and disposest of them according to thy good pleasure, and who hast now called thy servant, our sovereign Lord, the King Charles III, to the throne of this realm, let thy wisdom be his guide, and let thine arm strengthen him. Let justice, truth, and holiness, let peace and justice, and all those virtues that adorn the Christian profession, flourish in his days. Direct all his counsels and endeavours to thy glory and the welfare of his people, and give us grace to obey him cheerfully and willingly for conscience' sake, that neither our sinful passions nor our private interests may disappoint his cares for the public good. Let him always possess the hearts of his people, that they may never be wanting in honour to his person and dutiful submission to his authority. Let his reign be long and prosperous, and crown him with immortality in the life to come, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. In a moment of stillness, we bring our personal prayers and petitions before God. Given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications unto thee, and dost promise that when two or three are gathered together in thy name, thou wilt grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of thy servants as may be most expedient for them, granting us in this knowledge, in this world, knowledge of thy truth, and in the world to come, life everlasting. Amen. I invite you to stand and sing our final hymn, number 472, How Shall I Sing That Majesty? God, grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the Church, the King, the Commonwealth, and all humankind, peace and concord, and to us and all his servants, life everlasting.